Hey everybody, welcome to Calvary Family Time, a short midweek video to remind you that you're not alone and that you're a part of something larger than yourselves. We're glad that you are a part of our family. So kids, this week's children's message is from Mr. SCOTUS, or as he is inviting you to call him, Mr. Ed. Now, the older generation of folks may have a connotation that goes along with Mr. Ed from a very old television program that's probably even too old, kids, for you to see on reruns these days. But you can call him Mr. SCOTUS or you can call him Mr. Ed. And this week, he's going to talk to us, tell us some really cool things about water. Watch this.
That's good. Hey kids, Mr. SCOTUS here, or you could call me Mr. Ed if you'd prefer. I'd like to talk with you today about a very important substance. It's known as water. Now you might not think water is all that special, but actually it really is. You can do all kinds of things with water. You could drink water, you could swim in water, you could wash your hands with water, you could take a bath, you could take a shower. I mean, water is really useful. And in fact, did you know that your body is made up of more than halfway water? Think about that. Your eyes, or your brain, or your heart, or your arm, that's more than halfway water. Water's really interesting stuff because it's got these great properties. One of the properties of water is that on Earth, at normal temperatures, water can exist in three forms. One of these forms is solid water. Here's a little example of that. We call it ice. Ice. Now, water can also exist in liquid form. We usually just call that water. But there's a third form that water can exist at normal temperatures on Earth. Let me show you. You see that? We call it water vapor. Water vapor is where water is in a gaseous form, and it's usually intermixed with air. So we have those three different forms of water on Earth at normal temperatures. We've got ice, that's solid water, we have liquid water, and then we have gaseous water. That's pretty cool. Now, there's another really interesting property of water, and it's based on the fundamental structure of water. You may have heard some people call water H2O. Have you ever wondered why they call it that? Well, if you really zoom into water and you look at it at its microscopic level, you could see the individual molecules that make up water. A molecule is like the smallest piece of some given substance. So I'd like to show you something that looks like a water molecule. Here we go. Now, if you look at the structure of this little water molecule here, you'll see that it's got these two white balls. Those represent hydrogen atoms, and there's two of them. So that's where we get H2. And then at the center, we have this bigger atom, which is an oxygen atom. So we have H2O. And all the water in the universe, fundamentally, if you look at it at the microscopic level, it looks kind of like this. Now, I happen to have two of these little water molecules here. All right, so that's kind of interesting, but look at the shape of the water molecule. It's almost kind of like a triangle, right? That shape of the molecule gives water some really interesting properties. Check this out. For most substances, when you think about when they go from, say, liquid to solid form, something really interesting happens. Heat is essentially the molecules kind of vibrating. So water molecules, they kind of vibrate when they get hot, and they vibrate even more and more when they get hotter and hotter. But for most substances, when you cool them down, that vibration slows down, and the molecules get closer together, and then they turn into a solid form. For most substances in the universe, the liquid form, where they're all vibrating, is actually bigger than the solid form. The liquid form is less dense than the solid form. So the solid form, if you put it in the solid form will sink because it's less dense. But this is not the case for water. That's true for most other substances, but with water, something very interesting happens. With water, when you have it in liquid form, these little guys are all vibrating and moving around and such. But when they get colder and colder, because of those hydrogen atoms, they start to make a shape. And I'd like to show you a video of what this looks like. Here you can see at the top, we have water molecules that are in a certain structure. This is ice. This is frozen water. At the bottom of the screen, you can see all the liquid water molecules, and they're all moving around. They actually look kind of like little bugs interacting with each other and such. It's kind of cool. But you can see this water here is gradually freezing. The important point about this, though, is if you look at the water molecules at the top, they're actually further apart than the liquid water molecules at the bottom, which are all moving around. What this means is that when water freezes, it gets bigger. And this is why you have to be careful at the wintertime. If your pipes freeze, the water will expand when it turns into ice and can break your pipes. But it also gives us a really interesting property of water necessary for life. When God created these water molecules, he really knew what he was doing. Think about it. Solid water, that is ice, is bigger than the liquid water when the molecules are taken together. So what this means is the solid water, the ice, actually is less dense than the liquid water. So if you were to put solid water on top of liquid water, what would happen is the solid water would float. And I'd like to do an experiment to see if this is the case. So I'm going to take some liquid water here, and I'm going to take some solid water here, that's ice, and I'm going to drop it in, and sure enough, it floats. I've got some more solid water here, drop that in too, and it floats. Now you might say, well, that's kind of cool, Mr. Ed, but why is that important? Think about it from life's perspective. Think about ponds and lakes and rivers. At wintertime, when they get cold, what happens is ice forms at the top and it stays at the top. If this were a substance other than water, when its solid form forms at the top, it would sink to the bottom. And lakes and rivers and ponds would freeze entirely from the bottom up. But because on Earth, our lakes and rivers and ponds are made of water, they freeze from the top and then it goes down. What this means is all of the little plants and animals and fish and bugs can live in the liquid water underneath the ice. If it were to happen that the ice would sink in the water, all that stuff might freeze and die. So this is a really, really awesome property of water. There's one more property of water I'd like to share with you, and it's this. If you look at this water molecule and you look at its shape, I'd like to share a secret with you. If you turn the water molecule upside down and look at that shape, it's a hidden Mickey. Do you see it? So every water molecule in the entire universe actually has a hidden Mickey embedded inside of it. God really did some pretty amazing things with water. Now, I'd like to talk with you about water in the Bible. There's a lot of stories in the Bible that talk about water. I mean, there was God pushing back on the sea so that Moses and the Israelites could cross safely and get away from Pharaoh and the Egyptians. That was pretty cool. There was Jesus turning water into wine. That's pretty awesome. But my favorite Bible story about water is the one where Jesus walked on water. And I'd like to share that with you. It comes from Matthew 14, verse 22 through 33. And in the fourth watch of the night, he came to them walking on the sea. But when the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were terrified and said, "It is a ghost." And they cried out in fear. But immediately Jesus spoke to them and said, "Take heart, it is I. Do not be afraid." It continues. Check this out. And Peter answered him, "Lord, if it is you, command me to come to you on the water." And he said, "Come." So Peter got out of the boat and walked on the water and came to Jesus. But when he saw the wind, he was afraid. And beginning to sink, he cried out, "Lord, save me." Jesus immediately reached out his hand and took hold of him, saying to him, "O you of little faith, why did you doubt?" And when they got in the boat, the wind ceased. And those in the boat worshiped him, saying, "Truly, you are the Son of God." I love this Bible story. I mean, first of all, there's Jesus walking on water, which is awesome. But my favorite part of this story is what happens with Peter. Peter, when he focuses on Jesus, he gets out on the water and he's able to do something incredible, something miraculous, because he's focused on Jesus. But then when he looks away and he looks to the world, he looks to the wind, he starts to sink. The message that I take away from this is that when you're focused on Jesus, you can do truly incredible and amazing things. But if you take your focus off of Jesus, you can't, and bad things could happen. I love that story for that very reason. I also like to imagine what those little water molecules underneath the feet of Jesus or underneath the feet of Peter were thinking and what they were doing. I can only imagine these water molecules at the feet of Jesus. I don't know what happened to hold him up that way, but it must have been truly incredible. And they must have been so happy there because, I mean, think about it. Jesus created all things. All things were created through him, including those water molecules. So that's what I wanted to share with you today, children. I hope you found it interesting, and I hope you enjoy yourselves a nice glass of water.
So ever since the summertime, when we had people start coming back in the building, we've had these signs that say, do not use, on top of the water fountains. And that's really because in this time of COVID, we don't want to have people's mouths close to where other mouths have been recently, and we don't want extra places where people can be touching and stuff. But the water fountains, they do still work. And when you walk by them and you see them, let it be a reminder maybe of how God created water and how he uses it to remind people of how great he is. I do hope that if you're able, you come and join us this Sunday here at Calvary for worship. Our worship services are at 8:30 and at 10:15. And this week, between the two services at 9:30, we're going to have our annual congregational meeting. So there's no Sunday school this week, but we are going to meet as a congregation to rejoice in what God has done for us over this past year. It's been a difficult, a challenging year in many ways, but a year where we have seen God's faithfulness, and we're going to talk about that on Sunday. Everyone is welcome, even if you aren't a member of the church. If there's matters to vote on, of course, it'll be the members that get to officially do that, but anyone is welcome to watch the business of the church and to rejoice with us at what God has done. We call it Vision Sunday because it's not just about a dry business meeting. It's an opportunity for us to remind us of the vision that God has given to us as a church. And that's why in both worship services, the sermon this week is going to focus on a specific aspect of our vision, and that is proclaiming the transformative hope that is available only through Jesus. I hope that you'll join us. We'll see you on Sunday.